Say this Sulla fellow, this Moores. This I can see that he'll bite that calligraphy. So, he says, right, let us catch fish with that calligraphy. And I got caught. You know, I'm supposed to be more learned than most of you. You agree? In your mind, of course. You think, you know, Didat is a very, very learned fellow. In your mind, you think, therefore you respect me, you honor me, say, come uncle, talk to us, I'm talking to you. You don't know how poor I am in Arabic, you don't know. But you think this guy's great, because he's standing in front of you and talking, sharing with you his thoughts. I get caught, I'm in Pakistan. I deliver a lecture, thousands, thousands. After the lecture, you know, the people want to pump your hand for blessings. You want to get blessings. And I tell you something peculiar about the Malays. In Malaysia, in Singapore, not only they shake hand, but they want to kiss your hand. Every Malay wants to kiss your hand. Fortunately, you people don't go to that extreme. But they, your brothers, your cousins, your uncles, everybody want to kiss the hand. So at first I was resistant. I said, no, you know, you want to kiss my hand. I said, But for how long? You know, I wasn't this old. I was about 10 years younger than this when I went. Then I said, right, go ahead. What can you do? You're going to fight everybody? Huh? I don't want you to kiss my hand. And everybody is forcing. So I said, go ahead, now kiss. So the Pakistan is not so bad. It was not so good. They're shaking hand. There comes along a young boy, about 11 or 13 year old, bareheaded. A lot of Muslims, they don't put anything on. They don't have nothing on their heads. Even in masjids they come along, you know. They have different types of different standards. More especially the Indian Muslim is getting very bad with that. I'll be speaking on that topic. If the label shows your intent, wear it. It was announced, I don't know where, but it'll be in one of these talks. So this young boy hands to me these beautiful, I don't know what you call this, this beautiful calligraphy. He hands me like this. He's giving me like this. Can you see something written on it? Can you read it, Akhi? Try, don't be afraid. You see, I saw this as Allah Muhammad. And I wanted to kiss it. I'm still old fashioned. But people not giving me a chance to kiss it. So I put it in my pocket and carried on shaking hands. In Karachi, I had no time to take them out of the pocket. When I go to Dubai from there, in my hotel, I'm sitting on my bed and I'm clearing my pockets. I take them out and I read, Allah Muhammad, that's what it looks like. Then something here, gold, beautiful. All these are stickers. This is a sticker. You just tear it off and put it in the Quran. Abbana. So I'm thinking, it's Rabbana, Atina, Fid Dunya, Hasanatam, Wa Fil Akhirati Hasanatam, Wa Qina Azab An-Nar. That's what goes through my mind. Then something else I can't understand. Then I turn them upside down, the back. As it says there, the Lord's Prayer. I said, what do you mean the Lord's Prayer? This Pakistanis got something new. You know, at first I was jealous. These Pakistanis beat me. You know, we produce good books, wallah. You know the book that Akhi was showing? Our books are good. Look at this. Crucifixion, we have done more than 200,000 so far. Beautiful production. Free, of course. This one here, Arabs and Israel, Conflict or Conciliation. There are 16 four-color pictures inside, 16. Four-color job, beautiful production. 80 pages. Free, beautiful production. Our production is good. When you take it, you'll have to agree that it's good production. But this Pakistanis beat me. And Allah allows you that. Allah allows you that in the Holy Quran. He says, compete with one another in good works. Fastabiqul khairat, in good works, compete, try and beat one another. So these guys beat me, my Pakistani brothers. But now this is something funny. The Lord's Prayer.
So I turn again. What do you mean the Lord's Prayer? I was thinking, it's Rabbana Atina fi dunya hasanatan. Now I'm looking carefully, it says Abbana. So, this is, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, in Arabic. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And this is Allah Muhammad. Allah Muhammad. No, this is Allah Muhabba. God is love. This is not in the Quran. Allah Bari Ta'ala gives us some 99 attributes in the Holy Quran. He's Al-Malik, Al-Quddus, Al-Salam, Al-Mu'min, Al-Muhaymin, Al-Aziz, Al-Jabbar, Al-Mutakabbir. 99 attributes. But love, hubb, is not one of them. So God is love. Allah Muhabba. Allah Muhabba. They caught me fish. They caught me fish. What about you, my brother? What about the Pakistanis? If I can get caught, not only me, I'll go to Saudi Arabia. An old sheikh, Arab, Saudi. I show him. I say, Ya sheikh, I got this in Pakistan. He says, Allah Muhammad. He's reading, Allah Muhammad. And it just came out of him, Allah Muhammad. I say, Ya akhi, have another good look. He says, Allah Muhammad. I say, Ya sheikh, please have a good look. Then he says, Allah Muhabba. He says, right. It can catch an Arab sheikh. It can catch an Indian sheikh. What about a Malay sheikh? Catch anybody. New methods, new deceits, way of catching people. So you take it home, you kiss it, and you put it on the wall. You put it in the Quran. Then if this is a bit too small for you, of course, in book form. I don't know how many of you have seen this before. Put up your hands. Anybody has seen this before? This is a Cape Town production. You haven't seen it. You're not so lucky, that means. If you are not so lucky. This is a Cape Town production. Al-Kitab. You think it's a Muslim publication. You're going to kiss it and take it home. This is the Christianity. Christian mission is giving you a Bible course. Al-Kitab. Deceit. New and new ways of deceiving the people. Catching fish. And we are getting caught. Don't be too arrogant. Look at this. How they make you to keep, retain. In case you recognize, let's say you recognize that this is Christian mischief. It says here, Christian witness among Muslims. You don't read that. But now you see a Muslim, maybe a Ghanaian or a Nigerian or a Sudanese, the picture here. He's reading the Tasbih, Subha. What do you call it? Subhanallah, Subhanallah. What do you call that? Yes, Tasbih. Yes, we call it Tasbih. The Indian Muslims call it Tasbih. The Arabs call it Subhi or something. It says here on the cover, Inna Allah yubashiruki bi kalimatin minhu ismuhul Masih or Isa ibn Maryama. What are you going to do now? Kiss it. Allah's kalam. You recognize those words, don't you? You kiss it. And what you do? Take it home. You're going to burn it? No. You're going to tear it? No. You're going to throw it in the dustbin? No. What are you going to do? Put it next to the Quran. A snake in the house. You're going to look after this snake now. This is a snake in the house, but he's making you to look after it. New deceits, trying to catch fish. And books. They have written some 60,000 books against Islam. Professor Edward Said, he's a Lebanese Christian. He's a professor in America of the Columbia University. He says,